What's up, everybody? This is Peter again for Sports Hot Rumors and Debates. How are you guys today? Excuse my appearance with my lip. I've been having an allergic reaction the last couple weeks. I don't know what's going on. That's why I look like Rocky. All right, let's jump into this. You know, it's fun to be right. It's fun when you're awesome at picking things. And lately, the Arizona Cardinals have made me look like a smart man. I told you guys a long time ago, I've been telling you this for months now, the Arizona Cardinals are going to go 5-0. They are going to be a force to reckon with. They're probably going to win 11 or 12 games this year. Everybody was laughing at me, besides us Cardinal fans, obviously, right? But this is what I'm trying to tell you guys. For those of you who really diehard Cardinal fans, and even if you're not, but us Cardinal fans have went through guys like Kolb and Skelton and, Drew Stanton and all these just like... I don't want to get a little emotional here with how horrible these guys have been, but it's been so bad that we deserve this. We deserve this amazing quarterback in Kyler Murray. Now, anybody who followed me, anybody who watched me make videos before I even had this channel, I made some small videos talking about how desperate the Arizona Cardinals need Kyler Murray. And everybody wrote to me how crazy I am and why do you want a small quarterback? It's just your offensive line that needs to be fixed. Rosen is nasty. Kyler's going to be a bust. Now everybody is just going to just like eat their words because look at what Kyler Murray's doing. He is single-handedly the reason why we are 2-0. Okay, if we have a different quarterback right now, we're 0-2. Now, let's talk about the good and let's talk about the bad because I am an honest person, no matter how much of a diehard fan I am. The good, the great. Kyler Murray is unbelievable. Just breaks down defenses. Washington has a really good defensive line, and you know what? Arizona made them look stupid on some plays. Kyler, you know, he's made some mistakes with interceptions, but it's going to happen, you know. Sometimes, you know, it's hard when you get a lot of pressure. Sometimes you force the ball. It happens to the best quarterbacks. However, he just gets an A-plus no matter what. Second of all, DeAndre Hopkins. Again, best receiver in football. Another guy, another reason why when you have a top receiver, how everybody looks amazing. DeAndre Hopkins has just been the guy, bails us out when we need a first down, got wide open the first touchdown. Don't ask me. I guess that was just a defensive mistake. But, again, DeAndre Hopkins, another amazing game, 2-for-2. Let's talk about Kenyon Drake, because if Arizona don't have a running game, you know, there's nothing. Kenyon Drake had a slow first half. Second half, he definitely came on. He looked like Kenyon Drake towards the end. He made some great runs. I love what I've seen from Drake. You know, he definitely, like, when Washington was starting to push and come back, he started to get the first downs when he needed to. He looked really good. And you guys got to remember, there's no practice with these guys, right? There's no games. It's going to take a while before they get into it. You're looking at Arizona right now, and they're not clicking yet because a lot of teams are behind, and there's a reason why you see all these injuries happening. And it's a damn shame because there's some great guys who got injured. Now, that being said, let's talk about another, probably the bigger reason why Arizona is 2-0. Their defense has been unbelievable. Kennard has been incredible, right? Their defense has been just on top of it. Washington had the ball a lot. When Arizona failed a lot on offense, this is what I'm worried about. That's why I'm going to get into the bad in a second. Arizona had a big lead, and you know, if you don't put points on the board, if you start going 3-and-out and turning it over against good, Washington's not a good team. But when you play good teams, when you play Seattle, when Russell Wilson looks insane right now, when you play Seattle and the Rams are just like, I guess because Gurley's not there, they're able to just not worry about having to feed him the ball all the time. The Rams look tough, but when you play Seattle as the team right now, because San Francisco, I wouldn't be surprised they didn't even, they struggle and not even make the playoffs. They're in a tough division, and, you know, God, I feel so bad for both of them because I'm a Cardinal fan, and I don't want to see that. That's the God honest truth. I don't want to see that. I don't want to see nobody get hurt because that's just, it's a shame. Bosa's a great player. Obviously, I want them to win. I want to play San Francisco when they have their best guys, but you definitely don't want to see injuries. You know, Garoppolo got hurt. Mostert got hurt. I mean, I think Garoppolo and Mostert will be fine eventually, but when you lose Bosa on San Francisco, San Francisco is not going to go anywhere. They're not going. They're not going to be that powerhouse team. The defenses can get scored on. They're not going anywhere now. I'm just letting you know. I wouldn't be surprised they don't even make the playoffs because that division is so deep that Arizona honestly can easily win that and the Seattle. And how are you going to win if San Francisco? They're not going to be able to beat Seattle. That's for damn sure. So Just letting you know what I think there. And it just goes to show you how quickly, and I wrote this a million times to you guys before, all it takes is one injury to Bosa or something like that, that you're done. And look what happened, right? Next thing, let's talk about the bed. Again, I'm going to say this one more time. Everybody shit on me for saying that we need more wide receivers. We're like, what are you, crazy? You need an offensive line. And let me tell you something. How's the offensive line looking right now? The offensive line looks amazing. They're doing great. Kyler's able to break it down. But everybody tells me something about that. Look at CeeDee Lamb dominating in Dallas. Two good games in a row. CeeDee Lamb is going to be a stud. And I'm frustrated because I've been saying this about, we're talking about, Christian Kirk. And Christian Kirk, two games in a row, I see him in a combined three catches. Now, Christian Kirk had a great catch on a deep ball, which is what we're looking for from Christian Kirk, right? To get to stretch the field, to get a couple of those big catches, maybe finish with five catches, 90 yards, one touchdown, or at least five, six catches. Once again, why do you have two catches? Why, on a terrible secondary, why do you have two catches? And then, you know, this is going to be one of those things where when we play tough teams, this is going to come bite us in the ass if somebody doesn't step up. Larry Fitzgerald, again, was the guy who had to come in and show that he can get to be the number two. Right? Larry showed when he needed a first down, getting seven catches. He's doing what Kirk is supposed to be doing right now. And, you know, I'm waiting for also Dan Arnold to step up because we definitely need more from the tight end. And I was actually coming to the season hopeful for Dan Arnold. Now, again, it's early with Arnold, so I'm not too sure yet how he's going to do. But I expected a little bit more from him so far, right? The pluses have been, obviously, DeAndre Hopkins, Kyler Murray, he's been unbelievable. And Kenyon Drake is getting better, right? I'm just dying to see somebody step up. I'm waiting, maybe Sherfield can come in and do something. We need somebody else, and I wouldn't be surprised Kirk starts losing his job soon. You can't come to me and tell me justify two catches and one being a big deep ball. You can't. You just can't. I'm telling you, it's going to bite us in the ass when we play Seattle. It's going to bite us in the ass when we play tough teams. It really is. Arizona, look, this is no longer, they're going to do, maybe they can win nine games. This is a bona fide team that's going to be a stud team and that's going to go, and they're going to be able to go to the playoffs and maybe go to the NFC Championship either this year or next year. They are going to be a force to be reckoned with just because their defense looks amazing right now. Patrick Peterson got burned yesterday, by the way. He looked awful, okay? But I trust him enough. So just explain to me how all the guys who are talking about that we don't need offense, why it's not important to have more wide receivers. You can never have enough. You may have five or six. Isabella, again, he had a couple good catches, you know, but I'm looking for somebody to be that guy, and maybe Isabella can, but we need somebody else. Say what you want, but we jumped out to a big lead because Arizona's defense turned the ball around a bunch of times, and you can say whatever you want to say, but Arizona should have had way more points than they had yesterday. Look, Washington came within one score at one point. You know, there's a reason. When you play teams like that, you got to put points on the board. You cannot give them a chance to come back. Okay? Say whatever you want, guys, about what you think and how good we are, and it's only practice. But, okay, man, I've been watching the game for a long time. We will go 5-0. Arizona will be dominant. I'm waiting for Kirk to be that guy, and I'm going to be hard on him until I see him become a legitimate number two. Look at Roethlisberger yesterday. Schuster, there's number one, right? But Johnson stepped up. Right, there's a lot of guys, right, no matter what team you are. Tariq Hill yesterday had an okay game. He started doing good at the end. But Mahomes has two guys. Even yesterday watching Seattle, Moore stepped up. You have Lockett. You have Metcalf. You have guys that can score. It cannot be Arizona, DeAndre Hopkins. It cannot be that. Because teams will just eventually do it. And you cannot keep asking Larry Fitzgerald to be the best player. You cannot keep asking him to be Larry Fitzgerald. Right? I don't care, but you say, establish the run and all that stuff. Yeah, but you still are going to need players to step up. Kansas City has Sammy Watkins, who stepped up before he got hurt. You need somebody else, period. Anyway, guys, sorry, I'm just walking before I go back to work. Let me know what you guys think. And us Cardinal fans, expect 5-0, and Hopefully my video goes trending for calling it. So nobody called that. And I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.